and at the point where the queen is laying in those combs, you can take them out of the national box, put them straight into your top bar hive, and optionally, almost certainly, you want to shape more bees in there. And if you want to transfer the queen, you can, or you can get them to build it, to make their own queen as you would with any other type of split. So that's very easy and non-invasive in the sense that you don't have to do any kind of direct manipulation of bees. All you're doing is adding bars into the box and letting them do the work.
So could you do that sort of would you do that early in the season? Maybe if you've got a brood box which is sort of reduced over the winter, and just as they were starting to build again, could you then, rather than making a nuke from your existing colony? Do you see what I mean?
Effectively, yes, exactly that. Yeah. Effectively, it's building a hive up and then splitting it.
Yeah.
But you're doing it with alternate top bars rather than drones in your. And particularly if you've got an existing national that's come through the winter,
yes.
You've got the deep bombs, and you're thinking, actually, I'd really like to run a tip top bar hive. It's an ideal way of doing it.
It's a sort of grafting process, if you like, if you want a sort of horticultural parallel. But I would want to make sure they were in home building mode. At that point, I'd want to know that they were at the point where they're willing to build fresh comb, because the other thing they do occasionally do is instead of building new comb on here, they simply fatten up comb either side of it, and then you end up with a real problem, because then now you've got national frames that are too wide for a national hive, and you've got big fat combs in here because they fill up, because they widen the top area where the honey storage is, and you've got nothing on your top bar, so. I would always say, wait until they look like they're ready to build a comb before putting the stop bars in.
So just the sort of building up?
Yeah, in the build-up, rather than very early season, because very early season they're much more likely to fatten up the existing combs and they are to build fresh combs.
So in other words, when there's a good amount of nectar and pollen coming in, and you'll start to see bits of new white comb appear in the hive anyway, around the corners and around the edges. Last year, for my bees, it was a brilliant year for building comb and expanding, and I was able to make splits and do all sorts of things. This year, they have really struggled because there has been very, very little nectar coming in. And although I have been feeding them, if there's not much nectar coming in, I don't believe in feeding them excessively. I just am feeding them just to keep them going, because I don't want to take them out of synchrony with. You know, it's a period of relative dearth out there because it's been so dry and so cold, at least until recently. And therefore, that would not have worked for me this year. It would not have worked at all. It would have worked brilliantly last year. Mm-hmm. So one of the things, again, I'm just going to say is, you know, listen to watch what the bees are doing, and you may find, you know, what I would be tempted to do is I'd just put one in and see how they respond. Rather than saying, oh, this is going to work, I'll do more. Just put one bar in, see how they respond to that. If they go for it, they start building comb, then take some other empty brood combs out of the side that have not been occupied yet, and put some more in.
Can you do that with a nuke? If you've got a nuke and you've got the five frames in there?
You can, but the problem is in a nuke box, you've only got room for the five frames and you can't.
Yeah. And
when we we'll show you a hybrid. The hybrid but sitting out there is hybrid hive between the national and the TBH. So that's the other way of.
Okay, but you could. You were saying you could put it into a brood box, and have the five frames in, interspersed with probably six bars.
Yes.
So you would in effect be taking a nuke from a nuke.
Yeah. Well, suppose you bought a.
Or the beginning of a nuke from a nuke, because. Yes, and then you'll take those, what will be six top bars out?
Three or four? More likely three.
Okay, and then you would put it into your hive, leaving the queen and her brood in the original box and leaving.
More likely taking the queen with you.
Okay, and what do you do with the remaining bees in those frames?
Well, you've got various options. You can either. Then shake them all out into the top. If you want to do a complete transfer, shake all the bees out into the top bar hive, and then just discard the whatever's left. I mean, obviously, you can do a chop and crop on the odd
okay.
that's got brood on it. But if you're simply using a national colony to produce, if you like, a top wild graft.
Yeah, I've got you.
Yeah, you can then just let them do it. You can actually do it several times.
Let them carry on, and oh, you can keep doing it. Yeah. Yeah.
So as long as there's plenty of bees in there and you've got food coming in, I'm not saying you should overstress your bees.
Yeah.
You know, by reducing their numbers so much that they're in trouble. But
yeah.
as long as there's the right conditions to do it in, you could simply put another set of top bars in there.
Yeah.
And then you can take those out and put them into the top bar hive as well.
Okay.
Reinforce that.
Into the same top bar beehive. Ah, I see.
I suppose,
yeah.
But, you know.
Got you. Thank you.
There are various ways of doing it.
Okay, that's just coming up to break. A little. Oh, I got my sound system switched on.